In this video, I want to show you how to calculate the amount of concrete that we're going to need for this slab on ground. Now, there's a couple of things a little bit complicated about this. Not only is it L-shaped, it also has a rebate for the brickwork around the edge. And if you look at the section view, you can see we have a thickened edge or a footing with this 45 degree splay on it to reinforce the corner. So it's going to be a little bit complicated to calculate. So there's three distinct steps that we need to take to calculate this out. So step one, well, part of it, for a start, I'm not going to worry about the rebate. I'm going to consider it as a complete slab, and we'll take the rebate out of it later. So for a start, not going to worry about that little bit there. We'll just work it out as a whole first, then we'll deduct that later. So I'm also going to break up my L shape into two recognizable or two simple shapes, so two rectangles, and label those area 1, area 2, just so I don't get confused. And I'm also going to split this up into the slab itself, so the 100mm thick slab, and then we'll do the edge beam later on. Alright, so I've split that up into those different groups. Two different areas on top of the slab itself, and the edge beam. So, first thing I want to work out is how much concrete's in this slab, the 100mm slab sitting on top. So we do the two areas. So area 1 is 6 metres long down this side, and 4 metres wide. So 6 by 4 gives us 24 square metres. And then area 2 is 3 metres by 2 metres, so it gives us 6 square metres, so that adds up to a total of 30 square metres in this area. So 30 square metres on top of the slab. We know from down here the slab's 100mm thick, so 30 times 0.1 gives us 3 cubic metres of concrete just for the top of the slab, just for that 100mm on top. Not including the rebate, we've got to take that out yet. Okay, so that's the slab on top. Then what we have to do, we have to look at this footing. Now, working out this shape is not going to be the easiest thing, so what I propose to do is I'm going to turn it into a square. And basically what I have to do is I have to take this little piece off here and turn it around and stick it back into that corner there. So I need to work out what distance this is. Now, because this splay is typically at 45 degrees, that means that this forms an isosceles triangle, which means that two sides are the same length. Then we can just work out that half of this distance will also be this distance here. So half of 427 will give us 336. So 236. So 300 plus 236 gives us a total distance across here of 536mm. So I've taken that little bit off there and effectively, in theory, stuck it back on there to give us a new footing width of 536mm. So with that information, I can then identify all my sides, where my footing's going to be. And again, as we've done in similar projects before, we have to take off the width of the footing off the majority of these sides so that we're not calculating the corner twice. So for side A, 6 metres less the width of our footing, which is our 536, what we worked out down here, gives us 5.464. Side B, it's the same thing, we take off 536. And again, the common theme with any internal corner, we don't need to deduct anything off that side or those two trenches that form the internal corner. So for C and D, there's no deduction. And then E and F, again, we deduct the width of the footing. 536mm. So once we've worked all those out individually, we add them up and we get 21.856 metres all the way around our footing. That's how long our footing is. So then the depth of our footing is 472 mil, and the width of our footing is 536. So we can use those dimensions, length times width times depth, or 21.856 times 0.536, remember we need it in meters, times 0.472 to give us a total cubic meters of 5.529 cubic meters just for the footing. So that's the slab worked out and the footing worked out, but we've still got to get rid of this rebate. So the rebate's a similar process to what we just did for the edge beam, but this time the rebate is only 150 mil wide. So instead of deducting 536, we're going to deduct 150. And again, the two internal sides, side C and D, don't require any deduction. So we take the 6 metres, take off the 150 mil, 3 metres, deduct the 150 mil, there's 2 metres and the 3 metres, not required, and yeah, same in the rest of the way around. So we actually end up with a total length for our rebate of 23.4 metres. Now, the depth of our rebate, or the width of our rebate is 150, the depth is 172 mil, two courses of brickwork. So length 23.4 times width, which is 150 or 0.15, times the depth 0.172, gives us a total of 0.604 cubic meters of concrete that would have gone into that rebate. So we actually need to deduct that amount from our previous two totals. So we can add our 3 meters for our slab and our 5.529 meter, cubic meters for our edge beam, add them together, deduct our 0.604 cubic meters for our rebate, and that'll give us a total of 7.925 cubic meters of concrete for this slab. Of course, we need to allow for some waste. So if we allow 10% waste, it'll give us 8.718 cubic meters, and of course we then need to round it up to an orderable amount or an increment of 0.1, so we'd order 8.8 cubic meters of concrete for this particular job. So there you go, that's how we calculate the concrete required for a slab on ground with a rebated edge.